Indicators, take 500.
Hi, my name is Megan Glenn with UNH Cooperative Extension, and this is part of the Stream Safari video series. Today, I want to get a little bit of context into what we're doing and why we're doing it. And I want to talk about macroinvertebrates and why we use them to look at water quality. First things first, macroinvertebrates. What are they? We're going to go into further detail in a later video about the specifics of macroinvertebrates, but right now I want to look at the whole picture. So macroinvertebrates are macro, things that are large enough for us to see with our eyes. We don't need a microscope. And then invertebrates, think insects, your flies, things like clams, mussels, things that don't have a backbone. So invertebrates are opposed to vertebrates, things that have backbones, like people, frogs, fish, salamanders. Some of the macroinvertebrates that we are going to be looking at that live in aquatic, freshwater ecosystems, they include things like stonefly larvae, mayfly larvae, mosquito larvae, blackfly larvae, dragonfly nymphs. Do you see a pattern? A lot of the things that we're looking at are things that fly around in the spring, summer, and fall, things that we may like, things that we might not like so much, but they all have one thing in common. They start their lives out in the water, in fresh water. And one of the great things about macroinvertebrates is that they don't move around so much. They're pretty much stuck where they are, which makes them very easy to study. Macroinvertebrates are great because they also are highly adapted to live in certain conditions, to live in certain habitats. We're going to talk about habitats again in a later video. But macroinvertebrates can only live within a certain set of conditions. So think of a palm tree. We don't have palm trees here in New Hampshire because New Hampshire doesn't have the right conditions for a palm tree to survive. So for example, stonefly larvae and mayfly larvae can really only survive in clean water, water where there is not a lot of pollution. If you have a lot of these species, then that's a good indication that you have good water quality. If you're only finding species like leeches, blackfly larvae, aquatic worms, that's an indicator that you have poor water quality. Not because those leeches are there, because leeches can tolerate a wide range of conditions. It's really the diversity of species that you're finding in your water body that help indicate the quality. Hope that's helpful. I look forward to discussing more about water quality with you.